This may answer why some people get severe COVID-19. Experts know that some people with COVID-19 may have mild or no symptoms, but others may develop serious symptoms regardless of their health status. So why does it happen to these individuals? A new study offers an insight into it, and it will take you to the battlefield, the nose. According to Boston Children's Hospital, when the coronavirus enters the body, the first encounter is in the nasopharynx, the region where the nose and throat are located. This area is where initial clues can be found that explains how the virus gains a foothold in the human body. In the new study, published in Cell, researchers comprehensively mapped SARS-CoV-2 infection in the region. To do it, they collected nasal swab samples from 35 adults with COVID-19 from April to September 2020. These adults either had mild, moderate, severe, or critical symptoms. They also obtained samples from 17 controls and 6 patients who were intubated but didn't have COVID-19. The mapping took a lot of effort. Researchers had to sequence the RNA of each cell, one cell at a time, per sample, which is an average cell count of 562. Their efforts showed them which cells were present, which had RNA from the coronavirus, and which genes within cells were enabled and disabled during response. Results revealed that epithelial cells lining the nose and throat underwent big changes when the virus enters the nasopharynx. Mucus-producing secretory and goblet cells were tanking as mature ciliated cells suffered heavy losses. The latter is responsible for sweeping the airways, and with severe losses, immature ciliated cells had to be deployed, believed as a way to compensate. The mentioned cells were also detected with a virus RNA and had more of their genes disabled compared to uninfected cells. The turned-off genes are involved in the productive response to infection. Here's the big picture. In patients with mild or moderate COVID, epithelial cells would initiate antiviral responses, particularly type 1 interferon, early to alert other cells of an invasion. In patients with severe COVID who required mechanical ventilation, those cells were muted and unable to use interferon. Other immune cells like macrophages responded, but their presence increased inflammation. With the findings, researchers plan to evaluate if boosting interferon response in the nose could prevent severe COVID-19. If it works, boosting interferon may be possible using nasal drops or sprays.